Hello, this is Vern, and today I'm excited to share with you five often overlooked, hidden, concealed signs, if you will, that the guy that you're interested in or you're with is not your guy. Hello, this is Vern. Welcome to another edition of VernMendez.com, the brother you wish you had, giving you advice and guiding you through the dating process and helping you understand men, and also sharing with you how to attract the kind of man you want and the relationship you're seeking without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, tricks, stupid techniques. This is why I'm sharing this with you, because I want to make sure that you have the life that you want and the relationship you want without having to change yourself in ways that are unnecessary. Now, if you have ever been with a man that is maybe not super exciting to you, even though he's your boyfriend, maybe the guy's pursuing you, you've been dating for a while, but for some reason, you can't put the finger on why this doesn't feel super exciting to you, let me share with you that there might be a reason why. Now, sometimes it has to do with you and your own stuff and your own baggage. Sometimes it has to do with what he brings to the table. So hopefully these six areas and these guides I'm gonna share with you are something you can compile together, run them against the guys you're connecting with, and understand if there's a reason that you're feeling distant or weird about something, that there might be more to it than just nothing. Okay? The first one is, let's say the guy that you're connecting with, who's pursuing you, whether he's your boyfriend or a guy that you're dating, doesn't seem excited about the future that excites you. And this is a guy who maybe is a good guy. He's an intelligent guy. He's not someone who's a player, but when he shares on paper, here's what I'm looking to experience. Here's the type of life that I want. I want a family. I want marriage and all those things. And when you have conversations with him about those topics, he's not excited at all. Like, he's telling you what you want to hear, but you can see that viscerally it doesn't move him. That is a little check, red flag for you to notice, right? Why? Because if it's something super exciting, he should express it in some way. And if there's consistent themes of conversation, future, family, trips, and he's like, meh about it, you might want to take a second look at that. Second, he does not light up when he sees you. Now, I'm not talking about the occasional he's busy or the occasional he's in a bad mood, but consistently, when you enter the room, does he light up like a Christmas tree? Does he smile? Do you feel that he viscerally feels some level of excitement and passion for you? Or is he just as excited as when he's watching paint dry? Why is this important? Because you want to create a relationship with someone that goes beyond a roommate type of experience. And if you want that, there's a level of excitement and chemistry that takes place naturally. When it doesn't take place naturally, he might have a different way of expressing it, but you need to really understand what is your experience viscerally and passionately with him, because if multiple times he's not lit up by you, it's not a sustainable thing for a relationship long term. Next one, he has extreme difficulty, or can't spend time alone with you without some level of distraction, whether that distraction is TikTok or YouTube or Facebook or a TV show or talking on the phone with someone or other people. He does not enjoy spending time alone, and he has to bring other friends and other family members all the time to fill up the space, because there's something missing there. Again, something to note. I think when it comes down to it, there's gonna be multiple times in a relationship, especially something that's super long term, where you and him will be the only thing in the room. And if you don't have the capacity to really enjoy your presence and enjoy talking about your dreams and aspirations and goals and philosophical conversations, then chances are you're gonna get bored and you're gonna start looking for other distractions in life that create a lack of intimacy in your relationship. Next one is, he constantly sees your limitations far more clearly than your strengths. Now, it is normal for a partner of yours, especially someone who's spending time, lots of time with you, to share with you, hey, here's an area of improvement, or this is, I didn't enjoy how you said that, or when you wake up in the morning, sometimes you're in a really bad mood constantly. I mean, that's one thing, but when that's the majority of the things he's sharing with you, when the encouragement to put down ratio is out of whack, because he sees more limitations, he sees more bad stuff in you than greatness, again, that's a sign that you may not be as compatible as you think, or your guy might be far more focused on shit versus greatness. Last one is, you don't feel like the best version of yourself around him. When you spend time with him, when you leave and go somewhere else, I mean, how do you feel? Do you feel more fulfilled? Do you feel more inspired? Do you feel more excited? Do you feel more capable? Do you feel more confident? Do you feel more you? Or do you feel more put down, more distant, less excited, and more doubtful? That's an important consideration. The person you spend time with, your intimate partner, should create, foment the ability for you to be the best version of you versus you have to put down your light in order to fit in the room. Hope these are helpful, useful, and insightful. If you are interested in learning how to enter the relationship you want, go beyond the skills that I shared with you right now. On the first link in the description of this video, there's a link where if you click on it, enter your name and email, I'll take you to a presentation that's free that will share with you this small training, how you can attract the guy you want in a lot less time, with a lot less pain than you've been doing it right now. If you like this video, please click like or thumbs up. And last but not least, if you're someone who, if you're honest with yourself, you've been watching videos, mine and somebody else's, you've been reading books, you've been doing things to change a situation, and it's not really changing, then you might really benefit from hand-holding and help. On the second link in the description of this video, I've made it so that you can click on and enter a small form, and if we're fit to work together, I can share with you how I might be able to hand-hold you through the process of attracting your soulmate without that need to feel anxious and worried and in pain. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.